My name is Janin.
My name is Ibrahim.
My name is Nofu.
Just like the last of that view, we will begin with the opening Quranic recitation by Hamza Khalilullah, followed by a translation by Samia Wakili.
Pass it on to our MCs to further elaborate on the theme.
Our program today is focused on many Muslim role models our children identify. These role models range from our beautiful history to our modern-day heroes. How do we identify a Muslim hero? Our criteria for the hero must be a practicing Muslim who is an example in our society or our youth. They must take pride in the practice of their religion, have overcome societal struggles, and persevere. These role models set an example from which our children can learn, identify with, and help in their journey. Today, we will be highlighting pathetic heroes, Muslim heroes, sport heroes, Muslim social activists, and Muslim celebrities, all of whom our children have identified with, helping to create a stronger Islamic identity.
As you can see in our program flyers, our program will feature one class level at a time. Each level will present an Islamic studies presentation, followed by a Quranic presentation, and then a recognition of the year-round award winners. The award categories that our students are being recognized for are as follows. Perfect attendance, most improved student, academic excellence, Quranic memorization award, and a citizenship award. To end off the afternoon, we will announce three grand prizes and will be selected by our esteemed judges who are here today. The three grand prize categories are as follows. Best Islamic presentation, elementary level. Best Islamic video presentation, middle and high school level. And best Quranic recitation. We would like to start our program with our most precious little ones, the preschool class led by Sister Siddiqa, Sister Rahal. They will be performing a nasheed called I Love Allah.
Plus, you can sit down.
and Sister Zakia. They will be performing at a sheet called Upsy Daisy.
Yeah.
Wonderful job, level one. The following students in Level 1 are award winners. The Academic Excellence Award goes to Dua Nadim, Iman Saleh, Zelimai Roshan, Iman Gill, Yasin Zayda, Jawad Uddin, Rayan Ahmed, Ahmed Gulay, and Zubair Ahmed. Citizenship Award goes to Safiya Al Rahman, Rayan Asif, and Nadi Qureshi. Perfect Attendance Award goes to Saim Ikram, Duan Amini, Shabir Al-Tazar, Rayan Asif, Fatin Adib, and Shalim Israel. Wow. Chronic Memorization Awards go to Rian Diela, Umaiza Ahmed, Anissa Khan, Iman Gill, Amina Ahmed, Zelmai Roshan, Safiya Ar-Rahman, Tasin Sayyida, Jawad Uddin, Rian Ahmed, and Ahmed Kulai.
Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam is our hero today. He always stood up to his belief in one God in front of the whole village, including his father. He was brave and fearless even as a child. Let's watch a video to see how brave he was.
There were many idols kept inside the temple, and the prophet started smashing the idols with his axe. One by one, he smashed all the idols, except for one. That was the biggest idol inside the temple. He hung the axe around the neck of the statue and left the temple. Who could have done this terrible act?
There was a young man at the market yesterday. One of them said, he was speaking against our gods.
I know this person. His name was Ibrahim, said the other. The people found Prophet Ibrahim and brought him to the temple.
Are you the one who has done these to our gods?
They asked him.
It was the statue here. Yes, that big one, the prophet replied. Why don't you ask him? He will tell you if he can speak. This angered the people further.
You know very well that these idols could not speak. Then Prophet Ibrahim said,
then why do you worship these idols who could not speak, nor do they see or hear? Have you lost your mind?
There will be me.
Teacher, the video shows how Prophet Ibrahim alayhi wasalam was very intelligent and spoke the truth about one God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Great job! Now tell me another reason why Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam is our hero.
He never gave up on his faith.
Even when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested him and asked him to sacrifice his own child.
Great point. Let's see another video.
One night when the prophet was sleeping, he saw a dream. In his dream, the prophet saw himself killing his son as a sacrifice to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The prophet went to his son and told him about the dream. Ismail realized that this was an order from Allah. Do what Allah has asked him to. He told his father. The prophet raised his knife and suddenly he heard the voice from the sky. He took off his blindfold and saw a sheep being sent from heaven. Allah sent a sheep to be sacrificed instantly by him. The prophet was very happy because his son was going to be alive. The prophet and his son had just passed the difficult test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
So we learned today, Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam is our hero and a true leader because one, he stood up for his faith, for his belief, and one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even though his father and the whole village were against him. Two, he was fearless and brave. Three, he was able to make others follow him, not to believe in idols and to believe in true God. That's all for today, class.
Wa arsala
owner of the elephant who intended to attack the gazelle, but Allah destroyed them and made them a sermon over the ages.
Grant blisses and blessings on Quraysh by defeating the enemy for them, to lead to faith in the messages of Muhammad, peace to be upon him. Grant blessings on Quraysh by defeating the enemy for them, to lead to faith in the message of Muhammad, peace be upon him. Repelling the enemy from the Kaaba in the year of his birth. The smart person knows that Allah is capable of everything. Therefore, we do not disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Questions about Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Ibrahim told him that Allah SWT could give anything in life. He said he could give life and death. And Nimrod said that he could do that too. He brought two soldiers and he killed one of them and wanted them to be saved. And then Nimrod said that this makes him like Allah SWT. But Ibrahim, Ibrahim told him that Allah SWT brings the sun every morning from the east. And he challenged Nimrod to bring the sun from the west. And the next day, Nimrod was unable to do that. Now, please give your attention to level 3 for main presentation of Prophet Dawood, led by Sister Amri, Sister Sambrana, and Sister Naima, followed by the presentation of Surah Asr, led by Sister Fatih, Sister Manah, and Sister Sara.
Before Jai couldn't realize what was happening, down and his mouth started shooting pebbles from his lips. The pebbles shot out at the feet of birds and hit Jared all over his face. Then he fell down on the ground and died. The army of Belu chased the rabbit. King Belu rewarded Belu with a salon. After Belu died, Belu with a salon became king. Later on, one day, Belu left the salon a prophet. He sent a survivor called the Subaru to give up, to Belu the salon. Some of the parts of the Subaru are now lost and some of the parts are in the Bible. Prophet Belu from the salon was a very skillful person. He learned how to melt iron and use the iron to build shields for his army. He knew the language of the birds. His army had many birds. They used to carry messages from the gods to the king. The prophets are always over the salon, praised others to follow at the island, and tied them all to the other place. The prophets are always the salon was known for its fair judgments. One time, some sheep of a shepherd destroyed the crops of a farmer. Prophet Dawood of Islam gave a judgment to solve their problems.
When Dawood of Islam died, Suleiman of Islam came. Last of the Arab made Suleiman of Islam a prophet too.
Aisha Bey, Hasna Tajira, Mohammed Parekh, Mahdi Sitkar, Zainab Omar, Raina Jalala, Umayza Ahmed, and Anissa Khan. Oh, and can we please have the audience quiet down during the presentations?
Congratulations to the Level 3 winners. Prophet Dawood was one of our amazing prophets. One day, as Prophet Dawood was praying his prayers, he ordered his guards to not allow anyone to enter our land. Anyways, two people got inside. Prophet Dawood asked, "Who are you?" One of his men said, "Do not be frightened. We have dispute and we have come here in judgment." Then he said, "What is it?" The first thing he said, "This is my brother. He has 99 sheep, and I have one. He gave it back to me, and he went to the back." David, without hearing from the other party, said that the other person was wrong. Prophet Dawood immediately noticed his mistake and asked for his
Yes, I
We don't want to do it too far away from the mic.
Now, please give your attention to lock the door. They will be presenting a video on Prophet Muhammad's unlocking relationship with Allah, led by Sister Zamulia, Sister Seerah, and Sister Nida, followed by the Quranic recitation of Surah T, led by Brother Taha, Brother Adan, and Sister Sobia.
Thank you.
I also have a story I wanted to share with the prophet that I was told at a very young age. There was one time a woman who used to always throw trash at the Prophet every time he crossed the street. The woman hated the Prophet and she wanted to make the Prophet mad. She would show off to the time of the Prophet and those who remember once in a while. So every day after cleaning her house, she would gather up all her garbage, collect it, and when the Prophet would pass by, she would toss it at him. However, every time she threw the trash at him, she never got a reaction out of the Prophet. The Prophet just walked by peacefully, and she took it as if the Prophet had feared, so she continued to throw trash at him. However, the Prophet was praying every single day that one day that woman may recognize the truth in the way of Islam peacefully, so he continued to walk down that street rather than taking the alternative route. One day, the Prophet noticed that the woman was not outside to throw trash at him, and the Prophet was worried about the woman's whereabouts. The Prophet knocked on the woman's door, and he asked if he could come in, and the woman was frightened at first because she thought the Prophet came for revenge and she was sick. However, the Prophet told her that since he did not notice her outside, he was worried about her health. The woman was relieved and allowed the Prophet to help her around. The Prophet came every day to check on her and help her clean up, and when she recovered, she converted to Islam. This is talking about the Prophet's kindness and patience for how he disregarded the way others treated him terribly, and he forgave him for all their actions. As nowadays, a lot of us jump to conclusions about people, and we don't react in a peaceful manner. Now, could you please give your attention to level 5? They'll be presenting a video skit on Prophet Ayub, led by Sister Ramla, Brother Sadiq, and Sister Najat, followed by the beginning of recitation of Surah Mulk, led by Brother Muhammad, Brother Khalid, Brother Nurullah, and Brother Zahir.
So, Prophet Ayub is also known in the English language as Jah in Islam. He was one of the direct descendants of the Prophet of Islam. The means he came from the family of the Rahim of Islam. His wife was one of the descendants of Yusuf of Islam, and her name, according to some narrations, was Rahim. And his mother was one of the sons of Ruth of Islam. Ayub was sent to Huran, which is the south of Syria.
Awesome. Now, how can we think ourselves on this earth? Manifest?
always be patient and always have faith in our lives. That's true. Now, my four days will be different. We've got a lot of children.
Allah. Allah is the most exalted, the most forgiving, and He is almighty. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created seven heavens in which there is no flaw. He challenges those who disbelieve to go find and investigate for a flaw. And He encourages those who believe in Him to go and achieve big things and aim for high goals. Allah encourages us to keep trying. And soon, for the disbelievers, their sight will return to them humbled and worn out. Allah has spread the skies of the heavens with stars and meteorites to keep away Shaitan and his followers. For he's already created a punishment of the blazing fire for those who follow Shaitan. We are located in one of the arms of the Milky Way. Based on our location, we can see the stars and sky. If we were near the center, we would not be able to see the stars or even the sky. We should be grateful that we can see all the beautiful things in the sky. Thank you.
Just a quick announcement. If anyone lost a phone in the men's bathroom, they found it on the back at the ticket place, I believe. What's that? Here. If anyone lost a phone, please check in the back. Now for the awards. The citizenship awards go to Safa, Zainab, Saida, Iman Chaudhary, and Ayan. The academic excellence awards go to Kaisra, Kamal Faris, Saleen Khan, Taha Syed, Ayan Oman, Rahil Lasni, Arman Latif, and Noor Akbar. The Perfect Attendance Awards go to Raihna Nalbari, Ayan Villa, and Alia. Most Improved Student Awards go to Ayan Villa, Ayan Shahab, Safa Fatima, and Yasmin Dadgar. And Best Quran Memorization Award goes to Hamza Khalilullah.
Down. The question for you guys is, what should we learn from this hero? He came to him and told him there's many things to do, it was given to show sight. He helped the spiral sky, not to the sky, to the better one. And this is also required to the better one.
Muhammad Ali invented a new life. First of all, he was in black. Second of all, he was also in the black.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. It was narrated from Abu Hurairah, may Allah be pleased with him, that the Prophet, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, had once said, "A surah from the Quran containing 30 verses will intercede for him so that he will be forgiven." It is a surah, Barakal Lazi Biyadi Humu, or in other words, Surah Al Mulk, narrated by Al-Tirmidhi, Abu Dawud, and Ibn Majah.
الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وللذين كفروا بربهم عذاب جهنم وبئس المصير إذا ألقوا فيها سمعوا لها شهيقا وهي تفور تكاد تميز من الغيظ كلما وقالوا لو كنا نسمع أو
Your name wrong.
I'd like to take a minute to everyone quiet down, please. I'd like to take a minute to talk about the most important woman in Islamic history, also known as the Mother of Islam. Khadija radiallahu anha is a big inspiration to us all. She was a successful merchant in a time where society was male-dominated and dangerous. Upon her father's death, she took over his business and traded goods through primary commerce centers at that time. Her business became larger than all of the Quraysh tribes, tribe trades combined, and most acclaimed with the reputation of fair dealing and high-quality goods. Khadija radhiyallahu anha reminds us that really, anything is possible no matter who you are, as long as you put your mind to it. Now please give your attention to level 7 for video presentation on the American fencer, Iftikhar Muhammad, and basketball player, Hakeem Olajuwon, led by Sister Selma, Brother Saad, and Brother Salar. This will be followed by a continuation of the recitation of Surah Al-Mulk, led by Sister Dina and Brother Aksan.
Muhammad is a great Islamic hero. She is best known for being the first Muslim American woman to wear a hijab while competing for the United States in the Olympics. She could pick many sports where she decided to be a fencer because she could cover up in an Islamic way and perform a sport. She has won one gold medal and four bronze medals by the age of 30.
From a bad historian, Muslim girls can learn many lessons such as 1. Muslim girls can be sports. 2. There is always a moral way. 3. Dual identities are not cool.
I wish I could do a sport, but it's not fun.
Would you like me to show you fashion?
Sure.
Okay, that's it for today.
I guess being a Muslim doesn't suck it. Follow your dreams. Yes, I guess at MCC, would you play live from MCC? I'm Monday Schwartz here interviewing with this 7th grade girls asking about the hero of the country. It is Jenna, Vishal, and Isaac. Jenna, what is the main message you can get out of this club?
You can do anything in a halal way.
So, give me an example of something you can change to make it halal.
You can alter the seams on your basketball uniform so they cover your halal.
Isa, how are your struggles similar?
We both need to stay modest and cover up. It doesn't stop us from being Muslim and following our Muslim.
Thank you all for joining me. This is FCC at least 7. This is Crawford from Deja.
He shows the members of the Islam. An example of this is that
When traveling during the basketball season, the officer taxied to the mosque to listen to friendly noise, and then people offered him to give his best, he said no. Just because he's a famous person doesn't mean that he needed to be taken everywhere. And this inspired me to play more games in public relations because he raised his dog prey and ate a prey.
The outstanding
method
of taking a mosque is that he got NBA player of the month he was passed.
Including NBA all passing, so this makes me get really inspired by because he was a regular Nigerian boy who so worked hard to achieve his dreams. This proves that anything is expected and if you work hard, you may be successful.
One example that always inspires me is when I'm fasting and it's difficult for me, especially during sleep. But when I think I have a bad, I think about working a lot to win one of the finals off. And that gives me the strength and the energy to do.
As Muslims might ask it, we can still do great things and that's not an excuse to
try
harder.
And this is what it's going to be. Change his name to his
name
to
Brian. He also changed his name from a king to a king to be closer to a Russian person. He didn't know much about his father because of his name.
The King Obama was just one of them running back to me. There was an incident where a third of the King of Obama was black. But a lot of us continue to be faithful. This inspires me to be strong and faithful in the teaching words.
MashaAllah, level 7. The following students in level 7 receive awards. They will now do a recitation.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
of أيصف بكم الأرض فإذا هي تمور أم أمنتم من في السماء ولقد كذب الذين من قبلهم فكيف كان نكير أولم يروا إلى الطير فوقهم صافات ويقبض ما يمسكهن إلا الرحمن إنه بكل شيء بصير أمن هذا الذي هو جند
Zahra Umar, Aisha Asim,
Zain Salah, Salma Razek, Soha Ahmed, Aiza Khan, Kaif Jumani, Ryan Ahmed, and my beautiful young sister, Halima Atik. Perfect Attendance Award goes to Hiba Adil, Aisha Asim, Zahra Omar, Jannat Beg, Sabreen Abdul, and Hadia Ashraf. Most Improved Award goes to Aisha Asim, Naila Salman, Sami Abdul, Mansoor Dadgar, Asim Ahmed, and Hamza Mahmoud. Best Quranic Memorization Awards go to Jannat Beg, Maryam Siddiqui, and Mansoor Dadgar.
Us Muslims. She shows us the power of perseverance and faith. She gave many Muslim girls an opportunity to be well-educated so that they may one day impact the world.
And this is what we as Muslims should take from this. She has shown us that Muslims can make a change, and that we are capable of making people aware of the problems in the world. There are many around the globe who only see Islam as a violent religion, a terrorist organization that wants to bring chaos everywhere it goes. And Allah has shown us that that's not true, that Muslims can solve problems and bring peace to this world. We as Muslims should also strive to show the world what Islam really is, a religion of peace and tranquility. Now, let's look at another Islamic role model, Muhammad Ali.
Cassius Clay, born and raised in Louisville, Kentucky, and began training as an amateur boxer at 12. At 18, he won a gold medal in the light heavyweight division at the 1968 Summer Olympics. Clay then converted and changed his name to Muhammad Ali, which he called him. And he called Clay his slave name. He set an example for racial pride for African Americans and resistance to white domination. In 1996, he would not enlist, citing his religious beliefs in opposition to the U.S. involvement in the Vietnam War.
So as many of you know, Muhammad Ali converted to Islam in 1964, and this is because he admired the peace in society which Islam brought. Islam had helped him through hard times, as well as Muhammad Ali had stated that converting to Islam was the most defining moment of his career and his life.
Ali transformed himself from being merely a boxing champ to a champion of his people. He spoke out against injustice and racial inequality, and he was frequently misunderstood by the media, which at the time was mostly white. In March 1966, after Ali's draft status was reclassified, and he became eligible to serve in the military, the champ made headlines around the world when he refused his induction into the U.S. Army Corps. He became a popular speaker on college campuses during his exile from the ring, and in 1971, his conviction was overturned by the Supreme Court in a unanimous vote. He donated over $1 million in medical aid to the country as a protest against the U.S. economic embargo.
Muhammad Ali was a single strong in America.
He gave us confidence to be proud of our religion, and he was not afraid to speak what was on his mind, especially when it was coming from a Muslim African-American man at the time. Even when he got stripped of his heavyweight championship and got thrown in jail, he stayed strong in his faith. This shows us that no matter how hard you get, you have to stay strong in Islam and trust that Allah knows what is best for you. Thank you.
من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم أمن هذا الذي يرزقكم إن أمسك رزقه بل لجوا في عتو ونفور أفمن يمشي مكبا على وجهه أهدى أَمَّنْ يَمْشِي سَوِيًّا عَلَى صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ قُلْ هُوَ الَّذِي أَنْشَأَكُمْ وَجَعَلَ لَكُمُ السَّمْعَ وَالْأَبْصَارَ وَالْأَفْئِدَةَ قَلِيلًا مَا تَشْكُرُونَ قُلْ هُوَ الَّذِي ذَرَأَكُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَإِلَيْهِ تُحْشَرُونَ ويقولون متى هذا الوعد إن كنتم صادقين صدق الله
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل إنما العلم عند الله وإنما أنا نذير مبين فلما رأوه سيئت وجوه الذين كفروا وقيل هذا الذي كنتم به تدعون قل أرأيتم أهلكني الله ومن معي أو رحمنا فمن يجير الكافرين من عذاب أليم قل هو الرحمن آمين
أَرَأَيْتُمْ إِنْ أَصْبَحَ مَاؤُكُمْ غَوْرًا فَمَنْ يَأْتِكُمْ بِمَاءٍ مَعِينٍ.
Or who is it that could provide for you if he should withhold his provision, or they persist in rebellion and aversion? Then is he who is walking fallen on his face better guided, or he who is walking upright on a straight path? Say, it is he who has created you and made for you hearing and sight and hearts. Little thanks is that you give. Say, it is he who has dispersed you in the earth, and to him you shall be gathered. And they say, when will this promise be fulfilled, if you are truthful?
Say, the knowledge is only with Allah, and I am only a clear warner. Then, when they will see it approaching, the faces of those who disbelieve shall be distressed, and it will be said, this is what which you used to call. Say, have you ever considered if Allah should destroy me and those with me, or should bestow mercy upon us, who then will save the disbelievers from painful punishment? Say, he is the beneficent, we have believed in him, and upon him have we put our trust. So you will come to know who is in clear error. Say, have you considered if the water of your well should sink into the earth, then he will bring you the flowing spring water.
MashaAllah, Levelings. Now the following Leveling students have received awards. The Citizenship Award goes to Mansoor Dadgar and Salia Afreen. The Academic Excellence Award goes to Haroon Mubeen and Salia Afreen. Perfect Attendance Award goes to Ayan Khan, Ibn Fakhri, Haroon Mubeen, Kaif Jilani, Mansoor Dadgar, Mohammed Anjum, Giselle, and Shirin Ahmed. Most Improved Awards go to Nayab Anmar Arwar and Wida Afsar. Congratulations. That was a great presentation by Level 8. Muhammad Ali teaches us that it's okay to ask questions and that Allah encourages us to understand and seek knowledge. However, Muhammad Ali never forgot that Allah was the greatest and his creator. And we should be reminded that no matter what, how powerful we feel in this world, Allah is still our creator and we should remember him. Now please give your attention to high school for a video and live presentation on Halima Aden, led by Sister Rabia and Brother Sam.
Halima Aden, she is a Muslim quality man. She is born at 10:17 and grew up in Kenya left. She goes to the U.S. with her mother and brother, and she was deaf. So aware that they got either later, and she went home to be like the home. She faced eating, boring, and adversity for her parents, and her parents and her children.
And she was deaf. And she gave birth to
I'm going to go to the next one.
We strive to please our Lord. We strive to escape the status of God's self reproach. We strive to meet the standards of Mahal al Jahan. Listening to your right and change the standards set for us by society, standards set for us by Allah.
We are not going to have a receiving on our right, and all we have ever done is right. Now we are leading the way to a better future. Now our words will be heard. Now our times will change.
Lima Aiden, Gibson Thomas, Linda Suntour,
Hafsa Musa,
Zanira Kora,
Jonathan Schwab,
Shayla Khan.
Remember these names, remember these faces. We are the ones who don't wait for us to do things first.
MashaAllah High School, that was awesome. The following students in high school received awards. Citizenship Award goes to Zanera Parekh and Hadi Rahmani. Academic Excellence goes to Rabia Rahimi. Perfect Attendance goes to Sadia Hussain. And the Most Improved Student Award goes to Malik.
Alhamdulillah, this year, MCC Sunday School has started a special needs program for our community with the help of Mohsin. Mohsin is a nonprofit organization that strives to create a better understanding of disabilities in our communities and building a better future. In our program, all special needs students are able to get one-on-one attention from our dedicated student volunteers and learn at their own pace. Representing this class is MCC student Safwan Hussain, who will be reciting Surah Fatiha with translation.
All praises for Allah, Lord of the world. We see Allah is great and merciful. He takes care of all creatures made in His love. The most gracious, the most merciful. He is the one who gives us our family, our home, and everything we see. The most important, He gave us a command to look at how to live. Master to the end judgment. You want to understand? We will all gather together again for the Allah. You are alone in the riches, and you know who we ask for help. We say to Allah that He is the only one we pray to, and He is the only one we make to see, and He is the only one to ask for help. It is the Allah the pain,
Thank you.
Following students in our special needs class received awards. Most improved student award comes up to her, and best chronic memorization is a point of saying. Time and love, that concludes our performances for this afternoon. What talent do students have at MCC? Takbir! Now we'd like to give a few moments to our esteemed judges who have been evaluating throughout the program, tally up the results for our final set of awards. So Iman Tahir, who is one of our judges, has been working with us, with the mosque, and we'd like to thank him for his dedication and all the work he puts into our program. He's guided our youth and community as well. As well as Qari Amar, he has been with us for many years and enhanced our Quranic program and taught so many students the joy of memorizing the Word of God. Qari Amar has also diligently led our Tarawih prayers for 7 years, and we are excited to have him back this Ramadan.
So, who do you think is
going
to win,
Janae? Honestly, I'm kind of thinking about the 7. You know, my sister doesn't.
I wonder why.
My sister doesn't disappoint.
I thought high school was really good too. I feel like they're going to win a video presentation. Elementary, I think the skits, right? Who thinks going to win the skits?
Not sure actually, it's pretty close.
Really? I love Upsy Daisy. You know, that song can get stuck in your head for hours and hours. That song.
Yeah, it's really catchy.
You should tell them what they're judging us on, the students on, the awards.
Yeah, that's right. So, the awards will be the best Islamic presentation for elementary school, best Islamic video presentation for middle school and high school, and the best Quranic presentation.
Thank you so much for sticking with us. It has been an honor to be your MC for the past 2 hours. We know this is a very long program. I hope you're all still awake because the most important part has still yet to come. The three big trophies right here will be given to the award categories my MC just pronounced. So.
Yeah, you ready?
Who here thinks first grade's gonna win? Raise your hand.
Only one person?
Wow. Why doesn't anybody want first grade? Who thinks second grade's gonna win?
Oh, we see. Oh, that's a lot.
Now we're getting a lot more people up here. Who thinks third grade's gonna win? How about fourth grade? Come on, if you think there is up your hand, it's your class. Who do you think fifth grade's gonna win? How about sixth? Seventh?
Yeah.
Eighth? And how about that high school, guys? High school appreciation! Alright, guys, they're still tallying up the results. It should be in here in a few seconds.
Can we get a drum roll, please?
Can all the parents move up a bit? Move forward a bit?
Can all the parents move forward a bit?
Yeah, can the parents please move forward? Move up, move up, move up.
The results are in. Can I call out to all our esteemed judges? The winner for the best Islamic presentation from our elementary level is grade 2.
Can we get the grade 2 teachers and the students to please come and collect your trophy?
Thank you.
And for the last award of the night,
okay, oh yeah.
Can we help?
And for the last award of the night, can we get everybody's attention? This is the first time a Quranic recitation award will be given. So let's pay complete attention and see who the winners are. The kids and the Quranic teachers have worked extremely hard for this. They deserve all the praises. And the MCs will be announcing the award winner now.
And so, for the final award, for best Quranic recitation, it is Level 8, Come Back Up.
Thank you to all our Sunday school parents for your dedication and giving support to MCC
wonderful kids here every weekend. It is your children who are the future of MCC, and I'm looking forward to seeing you, inshallah, for another amazing year. As we plan for the coming year, we are blessed to have Imam Bakr join us. He'll be offering his guidance in making our school even better next year, inshallah. I will call upon Imam Bakr to say a few words and we will close the dua.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Honored to be here with all of you. All praise belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and salutations on the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is my third graduation today and third of six events before I get home tonight. So it's been a long day for me, but honestly, I want to begin by saying mubarak and congratulations to all the parents. Had it not been for your dedication and your belief, you wouldn't be bringing your children here. And so may Allah reward you and inspire you for everything that you're doing. Though looking after our children collectively is a responsibility and an obligation, but when we attempt to fulfill that responsibility and that obligation in which that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshallah there's great reward in it for all of us. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. In the weekend Islamic school earlier today, my oldest son graduated from the program. And I'm thinking to myself, as a parent, there's so much that we are required to do for our children. Yet, we prepare them. We prepare them for their life and the upcoming years. And the reason I say this is because, again, I apologize for bringing this up, but earlier today at the graduation that I happened to be at, I actually had all the adults and students and children sit down. And I recognize one of the founders of the masjid that I happen to be at. Because had it not been for the dedication of our founders, of all these individuals who worked so hard in order to ensure that we have the premise, that we have the institution, that we have the teachers and the programs that we do, right, we would all be nowhere. And I wanted to recognize that individual, and I did. And in this moment, I want to recognize the entire community for believing in this institution, for supporting this institution, for volunteering at this institution to make it what it is today. And I also want to share what I shared earlier today with a lot of the individuals, that a lot of us here that are here with our children, right? We're here with our children today. But believe it or not, there will come a time very soon when we will actually be attending the Islamic school graduation of our grandchildren. Inshallah. Although it seems very far-fetched and a long time from now, but there will come a time when you will look back and say, you know, I remember that. My children used to go to Sunday school, my children used to go to weekend Islamic school, and here are my grandchildren going to that school. And there's a few of us in this room right now that are actually products of weekend Islamic schools at the local masjids in the area. And now there's come a time when we're bringing our children to these weekend Islamic schools. So don't take what you have here for granted. I said this earlier in the year and I'll say this again. However it is that you see the weekend Islamic school is how your children are going to see it as well. If you're going to value the teachers, if you're going to value the institution, if you're going to appreciate the rules and the timings of the institution, then naturally that's how your children are going to feel about it. And if otherwise, then that's how you're training your children to feel about it. And also keep in mind, I want to be very short, I won't be too long, but also keep in mind that you are raising young Muslim Americans. And I say this to every immigrant parent who's sitting in the room right now who thinks that they're raising Pakistani, Indonesian, Egyptian, Palestinian, Indian American, Indian Muslims. They're not. Okay, they're not. They may ethnically be wherever your parents come from, but the reality is that once they're 16, 18, 22, 24, they will be more American than they will be anything else in this world. And so please, parents, don't be in denial. Allow them to have that rich Muslim American experience that our institutions offer to them. Right? Don't be in denial. Allow them to appreciate, right? Just as our students earlier today appreciated the prophets, they also appreciated, you know, famous American Muslim personalities. Now my question to the youth class is, you know, is a fashion model really, right? A fashion model really a role model? That's a question that I have for you. And if I come back next year on a Sunday, we're actually going to begin with that in class. So either you be there to argue, or you better run away, because we have a long discussion ahead of us. Now with that said, I want to close by saying that as this and all of our institutions continue to grow, we want to see our children and students getting older, but I also believe that we want to see our staff and our teachers getting younger. Am I making sense? Right, we've had people that have been volunteering for years and years and years. It is now time for a newer generation, our teenagers, our young college graduates, to come back into our institutions and begin volunteering. But for that, in order for that to happen, a lot of us that have been around for years and years and years, we will only be able to facilitate that if some of us actually take a step back. Do you guys see what I'm saying? Do you see where I'm coming from? If we will make room for these amazing, fine, young sisters and brothers, then they will come into our institutions. And if we don't make room for them in our institutions, they're going to create their own nonprofits and go somewhere else. Right? The reality is that the vast majority of young Muslim women and men are not coming back to the masjid after they graduate from college. They're still volunteering, they're still fine American Muslims, but they don't find room for them inside the masjid. And so, Sister Shaima mentioned that I will be coming back next year on Sundays, not every Sunday, a few Sundays, every few months, I'll probably be here. But one of my goals, and again, this is with all due love and respect to all of our volunteers and teachers, is that I want to make sure that we bring in younger and younger teachers in order to teach our young children. Right now, this is not going to happen overnight, but if you do have a young child, you know, friends that you know, who can come in and be a part of our institution, let's bring them in into our institution. May Allah bless you all. May Allah reward you all. And may Allah protect our children. I want to close today with a dua that I've closed with twice earlier today. And it's verse 128 of Surah Al-Baqarah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ رَبَّنَا وَجَعَلْنَا مُسْلِمَيْنِ لَكَ وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِنَا أُمَّةً مُسْلِمَةً لَكَ وَأَرِنَا مَنَاسِكَنَا وَتُبْ عَلَيْنَا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ التَّوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ Oh Allah, make us Muslims submissive to your will and raise from our offspring a Muslim community submissive to you. Ameen. And teach us our rites of worship. And Oh Allah, forgive us. Oh Allah, you alone are the most relenting, ever merciful. Jazakumullahu khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.